Hi, Sandra here. Many of you have requested a video about a Poma lift. So here we finally are. Let's go.
In my very first Mighty Machines video, I had explained various ingenious ways to overcome what I call the impossible skilift problem. Building a skilift that has both left and right turns. You see, in order to deflect a lift steel rope, or cable for Americans, into a specific direction, a pulley must be placed on that side of the rope. This means that you cannot attach the T-bar's grip there, as it would crash against the pulley. The grip can only be on the outer side of the turn. For this reason, it is quite a challenge to build a ski lift that is able to deflect the rope both clockwise and anti-clockwise. In my video, The Impossible Ski Lift, I have shown three solutions to this problem. Keeping the deflection minimal by making only tiny turns, adding an extra loop on the way down to deflect only in one direction, and the most powerful one, adding an extra rope to rotate the grip away from the pulley. I've gotten so many comments to that video suggesting another much more brute force solution to the impossible ski lift problem. Installing guide rails that simply slam that grip wherever you need it to go. This is how the famous Poma lifts do it. And it's about time I bring you some nice slow-mo shots of what's going on here. Plus, the nice staff let me have a closer look at that magic release mechanism that has intrigued me for half of my life. So let's go ahead and demystify the Poma lifts. Also, thank you to all the commenters pointing out that clamp is German and the correct English word is grip, which I shall from now on use consistently. But first, I had to find an operational Poma lift. Those are rare in the German-speaking parts of Switzerland. Poma is a French company, and language borders are ridiculously strong. But while doing a family skiing holiday in La Suisse Romande, the French-speaking part of Switzerland, there they were. Poma lifts, scattered all across those beautiful mountains. I didn't have my camera with me, so you'll have to bear with shots from my phone, taken in the ski domains of Grimain-Sinal as well as Saint-Luc-Chandelin. Poma lifts are weird. They don't have a spring box with a cord like T-bar lifts do. Instead, the rider is holding on to an overly long pole that can expand like a telescope. That pole is attached directly to the grip using a wobbly but stiff spring. The pulleys are different too. Instead of lots of small pulleys, Poma lifts have random looking assemblies of small amounts of large pulleys and often just a single drum. But the weirdness does not stop here. The platters are stored in a magazine and only attached to the rope when they're needed. And trust me, the detaching mechanism is not what you think, but more on that later. As stated before, Poma lifts have the ability to turn in any direction. This beautiful specimen, Pas de Boeuf in Saint-Luc, uses this heavily. Check it out. This is one single ski lift. And as the name suggests, there is indeed no beef in sight. Pardon my French pun. So let's have a closer look at how this lift turns. Up appears to be the easiest direction, handled by this simple drum. Down seems to be a bit more involved. There is a guide rail that slightly lifts the grip, I think in order to counteract the weight of the skier pulling it down. When extra stabilization is needed, the down-deflecting pulley is followed by one sitting above the rope. Things get more interesting with the lateral turns. Some Poma lifts have the grip left and others right, so let's first study the case where the deflection goes inward, i.e. away from the grip, which is simple enough. The real innovation here is the fabulous outward turn. Note how the grip is located at the wrong side. It's about to slam into the pulley. But wait, what just happened? Let's check this out in slow-mo. So the guide rails simply slam the grip to the side in order to make it face away from the pulley. No careful guiding in advance. No avoiding the outward turn. Just bang. What doesn't fit will be made to. This is what I mean by brute force solution. Let me know in the comments whether you agree. As you can see in these shots, those turns jerk the platters quite violently. Despite the spring, part of that jerk is transferred to the rider, making these lifts among the roughest ones I know. It seems that everything is jerky and wobbly here. Those platters are thrown around all over, only held in place by guide rails. Some of these lifts even have a top station that is mounted to steel ropes instead of a mast. It tumbles wildly as riders exit the lift. Part of the roughness is probably also due to the fact that many Poma lifts operate at higher speeds than normal lifts, typically 4 meters per second instead of 3, that is 13 feet per second instead of 10. It would normally be hard to get on a lift operating at that speed, but Poma platters are detachable. When a platter completes its journey, it is stored in a magazine where it waits for riders. As a rider approaches the lift, they pass a rod that engages an electromagnet, attaching the platter to the rope at the exact moment the rider grabs it, and they depart happily. A traffic light makes sure that there is enough spacing between riders. I really needed to know how the detaching mechanism works. So I asked the operator whether I could film this shot, and he told me, hey, why don't you go up the stairs? You'll get a better look. And if you see my other videos, you know that that's an offer I cannot refuse. So here we see the electromagnet operating. A single platter is transported to the attachment point, and there, this happens. I don't get it. Let's go for slow motion. Where is this clamping mechanism? Maybe it's in the releaser? Also, let's slow down to 8 times slow-mo. I still couldn't see any clamping action going on, so I asked the operator. Turns out, the grip consists of these two parts, and that's it. There are no movable parts. The way the platter is attached to the grip will put weight on one side only, jamming the grip against the steel rope. That friction is enough to carry a passenger, whose weight adds to the jamming force. Upon arrival at the bottom station, the grip is simply aligned with the steel rope, taking off the jamming weight and allowing the rope to move freely through the grip. Well, I guess that's yet another brute force solution hidden in these lifts, one that I had no idea about. Knowing this, the ride feels a bit odd, knowing that there's no actual component preventing the grip from slipping on the steel rope. But the lift has been operating since 1973, transporting up to 700 people per hour, so I guess the physics do check out after all. Still, personally, I do prefer the elegance of the whole Stocklift, even though Poma makes it look like overengineering. I'm looking forward to reading your opinion in the comments. By the way, did you know that Poma also makes other kinds of lifts, such as this chairlift? They also have detachable chairlifts, and this one looks a lot like a Leitner, including the grip. A quick research showed me that both companies now belong to the HTI group, so that explains that. So this is it for the Poma lift. If you'd like to support my independent work, please consider becoming a Patreon. A big thank you to my current Patreons, Mox, Adivote, John, Peter, Jure and Alex. Also, I've been working on the next video since autumn 2023. It's going to be a big one, about a ferry train. I can't wait to bring it to you, but there's still much work left to do. Until then, have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.